Atomic batteries to power. Provide the speed.
Now, everything old is new again. America's entertainment pop culture talk show.
It may well possess a rudimentary intelligence.
I'm trying to think, but nothing happens.
Felt a great disturbance in the force.
Hello, I'm Mr. Ray.
Come on, Mark, like a dog for me.
Where's the goodies?
Leave the gun. Take the cannoli.
I'll bet you wouldn't have done anything like this if Mom and Dad were here.
You filthy criminal.
Excuse me while I whip this out.
Go ahead. Make my day.
Here are your hosts, Douglas Viviani and David Cohen.
Let's see if we can get a little bit of advice from the master himself.
I understand. Dr. Watson, I understand completely where you're from. This guy, this balls actor, I got to deal with. He's an absolute nut. Sherlock Holmes,
head, don't listen to this guy.
The Sherlock Holmes,
right.
He's taking all the credit.
These are legitimate. They're all legitimate, I'm telling you.
Pumpkinhead, I'll give you a little piece of advice. Get as far away from this gentleman as you can.
Oh, man. No, that was great. In fact, you know, you guys are really good. It was great. What you did was a blast. You guys should continue to do that. I don't know how often you do it on your show, but it's not only fun, but it's fun for the audience because you guys are good.
Is it fun for the audience? I don't know. This is Douglas Viviani with our very own Mel Blanc himself, David Cohen.
How much should we pay that guy to...
How about that? That was Rob Paulsen. If you don't know, he's Pinky from Pinky and the Brain, Yakko from the Animaniacs, which is coming back, Raphael, and later he did Donatello from the Teenage Ninja Mutant Turtles, and over like 100 other voices all over the place. So he's a man of experience. We had a great interview with him, Rob Paulsen. He's overcome cancer, throat cancer. He's written a book about that. It's a lot of fun, the book, because he really has a great attitude. But was he just puffing? Was he just like, I did that, put him on the spot, he's a guest, he's promoting this and that? I wonder if he really was just kind of being Hollywood with us. What do you think, David Cohen?
Well, there's probably some truth to what he was saying. I mean, if he really hated it, I think you'd be able to, you know, glean that from his comments. But, you know, he sounded fairly genuine to me.
I would only agree with you on one level, because I cut down like 5 minutes of accolades to those couple of seconds. So if you were in Hollywood and you kind of liked it, but kind of, yeah, these guys are nice, it's not really that good, you would just say, yeah, it was great, guys. Okay, let's talk about my book, right? You wouldn't go on and on about it, I guess. Who knows? Two characters trying to figure out another character. Speaking of characters... Yes.
Go ahead, because I think you're setting up the theme of today's show.
Exactly. Today
go a long way towards, you know, reinforcing or maybe discrediting that whole critique.
Exactly. The question is, what's the story with the characters on Everything Old is New Again, which you now basically hear on, we would say, on a regular basis and mostly on, like, the holidays. We kind of use those shows to feature these characters. We have done so for the last 6 years, 7 years now, and we're wondering what's up and what's kind of a, can we get some critique or what have you. So, we have reached out to the director of the Maplewood Players Theater that performs and is located in the St. Catherine's of Siena Church, the basement there. And it's in Maplewood, New Jersey. And she is Michelle DeFranco. And David Cohen, this is someone that's going to try to give us a objective opinion, because she, like most people, have an opinion about this, but she has, like lots of people, unfortunately, never heard our show. So we're going to try to, you know, get a nice fresh slate here with Michelle DeFranco, director of, and I should say theater director of, the Maplewood Players Theater. Michelle, welcome to Everything Old is New Again.
Thank you so much, Douglas. The first thing I'd like to say is that I'm actually been promoted to artistic director of the Maplewood Theater Players, just recently appointed.
How did I miss that? I'm sorry.
Congratulations.
Yes, congratulations.
Thank you.
Was that in the local courier? Did anybody announce that?
I think there was a press release. I'm not sure how widespread it was, but it was out there.
All right. I've got to look. You know, if it's on the internet, we can find it now these days. So I'm looking forward to pulling that up maybe in a break and seeing the review that we get. But so happy to hear that. You have a lot of experience and you've not heard the show. Can I ask you why that is?
I haven't heard of the show, mainly because I tend to listen to radio, NPR, and more...
serious kind of stuff.
Well, yeah, I mean, I enjoy the finer things, and part of that is listening to some Shakespeare theater productions from different Renaissance festivals that have gone strictly audio now that we are in lockdown.
Interesting. Pandemic. So it sounds like you're more of a podcast kind of a fan, it sounds like.
Actually, I'm just really into Shakespeare and modern interpretations of the Bard. So whenever I find a theater company who is doing audio productions or radio plays of Shakespeare, I tend to spend my time listening.
Gravitate towards that. It sounds like you would have an affinity to one of our characters. You know, Mr. David Cohen, we're familiar with the character of Fondue Guy. We'll get to that. Let's start the ball rolling here, if you don't mind. We're running out of time. And it's...
we just started.
I know, but Michelle has a lot. You know, this Michelle, she has a lot to say and very interesting at that. But it is radio, so we do need to move along. So here's the idea. We're going to play you a clip. This one's long. It's 2 minutes. So, but then I'd love to hear your critique of what we have to say and what's going on. And, well, here we go. Let's just dive into it. Holmes and Watson.
Here's what I can deduce, Watson. And tell me if I'm wrong. One, two highly educated individuals who chose to focus their talents not on advancing the world, but rather on arguing about mundane topics. Two, they wielded great power over the masses through this technology, and the masses viewed them as gods, which leads me to the conclusion that this is evidence of the end of civilization as we know it.
I've got to agree with you on many of these points. Well, all I can tell you is that, Holmes, at some point in time, whatever it is in the future, you are a very known individual. You're quoted. Your philosophies of deduction last long beyond your years.
Well, I'd be nothing without you, my loyal servant, Watson, so thank you greatly, and let's only pray that this whole thing is just a bad nightmare.
I'm glad that I went to college, to medical school, and I did internships, and I did all of this to become a doctor, to become your servant. That's very happy to hear.
That's the path you chose, Watson, and I admire you for it.
We'll be back next week.
Oh, we're back for the podcast here.
I thought Watson was excited.
I'm so glad.
I thought Watson was a sidekick, wasn't he?
I mean, he sounded like one.
It's like, he is, but just the way he phrased it, my servant.
Did he call him a servant? I'm sorry. I'm glad I went to medical school to be a servant. That's great. Now, I'm sorry, Michelle, I went a little long on that, and it sounds like a little unprofessional there, but we just broke up. We were so enamored with what went on there. Michelle, give us a little once-over. What do you think of what went on there?
I think in terms of what I like to call the emotional truth of the moment, in such as, like, doing or acting naturally with a purpose is what we call it at the Actors Theater in Maplewood. I just didn't feel, I wasn't connected to the emotional truth behind it. It seemed a little shallow. It didn't seem to have a subtext or an inner life. So maybe I would suggest that maybe you do a couple of exercises before you do your show, some breathing and relaxing and getting in touch with the wants and objectives of the character.
Okay, well, you know, that's a good point. I will log that.
And so you didn't like it?
So,
well, I found it slightly one-dimensional.
Michelle, I'm going to interrupt you. I'm going to give you one more dimension. Here's a 40-second clip. We're going to add some dimension to what we just did there. Let's see. We followed that up. Let's see if this adds anything to the
Think
dimension.
That if that stock is worth $17,000 in your U.S. dollars in the year 2017, that
Holmes and I, I'm sorry, Watson and I should,
can't get the name straight.
Should get a share
of that. Have another scotch. Go ahead, have another brandy.
Yes, I will, Watson, in one moment. But in the meantime,
would
Watson...
Would you like me to buy it for you?
Yes, please. And I'm trying to determine how much should be translated into Great British pounds so that you and I...
Don't even bother. Don't even bother. You're not getting a dime. You're not getting one thin dime. You're a fraud. You're a PR man. All you want to do is promote your own image and have your drinks at the bar.
There we go. So a little something with part of, little.
So those are three characters, right, Doug?
Exactly. And we just had a couple of seconds. We'll carry this conversation over, of course, into the next section here with Michelle. Matter of fact, why don't we take a break for a moment? Michelle DeFranco from Maplewood Players Theater. We're very excited to have her here to critique Everything Old Is New Again. We'll be right back, right after this.
You're listening to Everything Old Is New Again, America's entertainment pop culture talk show with Douglas Viviani and David Cohen.
And Batman, irrelevant, completely irrelevant. What really? What is this guy going to do? Maybe he could work behind a deli counter.
Hang gliding instructor.
You know, he could. Someone can come up to him at the deli counter and he can help with there. You know,
we have no more corned beef today, ma'am. But. I have a nice brisket in the back. Let me go get it for you.
True.
Now we've got an issue. What do we do with the rest of those people?
Yeah. That's one union you don't want to piss off to.
That's true. You don't need superheroes to fight them.
We're back. Everything Old Is New Again. That was show 5. I just wanted to play that clip because it I could see the steam coming out of David Cohen's ear. We were trying to do a little bit of a setup there way back when, the infancy of characters, where he was doing a little bit there of Batman, and our then producer at the time kept on interrupting the flow of the conversation. He jumped on punchlines, he jumped on setup lines, he wasn't encouraged to do it, no one asked him to do it, and he put in his 2 cents right then and there. And David, remember those days?
Yeah, it was like it was like having a heckler in the audience, you know, when you're stand-up. It's like, what the hell?
I clearly, distinctly remember that. It was so hysterical that we had
it. Thanks for replaying that.
We really, literally, you could hear how perturbed you get there. We literally had to go to the bathroom during the break and talk about it behind his back and say, how do we get this guy to stop, you know, participating in our show? But we don't want that now. We have someone that's going to be participating, is participating, the artistic director of the Maplewood Players Theater. Is that the one making the left turn or the right turn? No.
You make the left turn at Carvel.
What street is that again? I'm sorry. What was the name of the street?
Ridgewood Drive.
Okay. So Ridgewood Drive and Maplewood, make yours is to make the left turn at the Carvel.
Yes. If you make the right, you're going to St. Catherine's of Siena Upper Church.
Okay.
We are the lower church.
Gotcha.
And it might look closed. It's a little boarded up, but we're in there doing our thing.
Okay. Sounds good. It might be some renovation. Look like there's some renovations, but who knows what's happening. Anyway, Michelle is here to critique and let us know. Our character is something we should or should not be doing on the radio. And Michelle, let me play you one clip here, and then we'll get back. I'll get a nice kind of a paintbrush from you of what you've heard so far. Right after you hear Barbecue and Fondue Guys talk about summer movies. And again, I think they might be cracking up. I'm wondering if that's a good idea to do. Let's see what happens.
I have another movie suggestion that you and I would, I believe, really appreciate this one. It's called La Flor. It was an Argentinian movie. And I think the reason you and I would enjoy it mostly is because of the time we would get to spend together watching it.
Why
the movie is 14 hours long.
What?
Yes, 14 hours long.
Say it again.
The movie is 14.
I don't even work 14. I don't even sleep 14 hours long. What am I doing 14 hours with you? In the theater? In the dock? All right, wait a minute. Let's just hear a couple of seconds of this.
Sure.
And the days grow short.
Esta película es así. Son seis historias.
For those of us who are not fluent in Spanish.
All
All right, let's get back to it. All right. You okay?
I have to hear that again. I didn't commit. I don't think I'm right the first time.
Then I'll come in.
And the days grow short. And they all.
Esta película es así. Son seis historias.
That's it?
Well, for those of us who are not fluent in Spanish, there are subtitles. So
I'm going to be reading a book on the screen for 14 hours, you're telling me.
Okay, Michelle DeFranco. There we go. Bond, the two different characters. We heard Holmes and Watson before, and right. Then we had to cut you off on that review a little bit at the end of last section, and we just heard a bit of Barbecue Guy and Fondue Guy. So what do you say?
Well, I would say that we have two levels of technique and skill here. I would say the person who portrayed the Barbecue Guy has a very, very advanced, maybe even an intrinsic understanding of the focus and concentration and emotional truth that you need to build when you're creating a character. I would say the other fellow that was playing the Fondue Guy, as you say, is a bit superficial, isn't really digging deep at character motivations. It just sounds like putting on the accoutrements or the trappings of a character without really having that subtext.
Well, we don't really need to go into which one of us, Doug or David, did the Barbecue Guy or the Fondue Guy. But point well taken. Yeah.
Well, I'll tell you what, I'm really getting to enjoy this show. This is a nice, this is really a nice point of view, a nice critique. I'm going to go one more layer here because I see what you're saying here. How about a clip of Barbecue and Fondue Guys imitating each other? Let's see what the skill is like, the skill level of being able to carry the characters through something of that. Sound like it to me that would be kind of difficult to do. Let's hear. Say it again. Toasted. What?
I'm going to read it like Barbecue Guy though.
All right, here we go.
You ready?
Yeah, go ahead.
Exactly.
There we go.
So you take your 8 ounces of bittersweet chocolate, you chop it, you got a cup and a half, and then a cup of heavy cream right there. You got it? Follow along now. And the 3 tablespoons of bourbon. It's optional, but I say let's do it anyway.
I'll tell you what, you're sounding terrific. Keep going.
And for the skewers, don't forget the skewers. You understand the skewers? I'm talking about skewers here. You got 2 rolls of skillet bread.
I know what a skewer. Oh, go ahead, yeah.
You get your skillet. You know what skillet bread is? You take your skillet bread. You cut it
what
into
what bread? What?
You cut it into... You shut up and listen to me.
But what's a skillet?
1.5-inch cubes. You got 2 ripe but firm. Ripe but firm. But firm bananas. Ripe what? But firm.
I'm going to have to answer you like the Fondue Guy. Let's see what the Fondue Guy will respond to.
Take a bag of...
I know what I...
Take a bag of marshmallows.
I now have a headache.
Then you basically put it on the floor, you stomp on it with both feet, throw it on a barbecue, and there you go.
That does not sound very appetizing to me. In fact, as far as I'm concerned, I'd like to have a glass of wine, some Beaujolais, and a little fondue, and that's all I would like to have.
Can I say that is the most intelligent statement I've ever heard you speak?
There we go. Some intelligence on Everything Old Is New Again. And that's coming from Michelle DeFranco, who will critique us a little bit there. Michelle, what do you think?
I think the person who portrayed, he was originally the Barbecue Guy, and then he was, you know, inhabiting the Fondue Guy. I just want to, did he go to Yale Drama or NYU School of Acting? Because I'm actually pretty blown away at how he can go back and forth from the characters. I'm stunned. I would suggest the other fellow who did the reverse fondue to barbecue maybe wants to come in on my Zoom acting coaching classes for a little refresher course.
Interesting. He's a little more shallow, is what you're saying, is something of that nature.
Yeah, a little more untrained, a little bit more amateur-y.
Okay.
Now,
what about the cracking up? You heard them laughing, these two laughing earlier, you know, during a skit, towards the end of the skit. And that's happened twice already. We've heard that. Initiated by something they felt was funny, but I don't know. Where do we stand on something of that nature? Like happened, like, you know, on the Carol Burnett show and cracking up in the middle of a routine?
Well, unprofessional, I would say.
Yeah.
Thoroughly, thoroughly unprofessional. I mean, you're calling attention to what you're doing. And I don't really think that meta sort of approach really works here in this like lowbrow scenario and forum.
All right. It's interesting you call it lowbrow because we can get even lower. We're going to hear a little bit of a Halloween show where we had some guests that came on the show, one being Al Capone and one being Leonardo da Vinci. And let's hear that, a very interesting review of different characters.
Well, just because history presents it a certain way doesn't reflect reality.
All right, so I guess, I just figured you'd be like a rough and ready kind of a
guy. I am rough and ready.
Oh,
what's your name, Doug?
Yes, you're...
I am rough and ready.
I don't want to give you my name because I really don't want to be followed.
No, I know who you are. Believe me.
All right, we got one more. Who is this?
Who is this now? Who is this, actually?
Hi, my name is Leonardo da Vinci.
Oh, I should have gotten it from that, you know, from the get-up, the costume. That's great.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you. I did the Statue of David. I don't know if you're familiar.
You know, it's funny because you sound like Al Capone would sound.
Al Capone would like the Statue of David. I know he'd like to steal the Statue of David.
I just didn't get that voice coming out of Leonardo da Vinci, but it's great to have you here. So, Leonardo, we have a selection of modern day for you.
Well, I'll be honest with you, it looks like a nice spread. Looks like the Last Supper here, to be honest with you.
Another famous painting you're referring to. Very
absolutely
good. You always pitch your work. That's good. Good to do. But one of the questions I have for you is, it sounds like you're probably good at barbecuing things, or is that just a coincidence?
I grow pumpkins in my backyard is what I do.
So, all right. Well, listen, help yourself. There's a whole spread out there. Different candy and sodas. And
it's not going to be my Last Supper, though, is it? Because I see Al Capone. I don't want to get too close to that guy.
I didn't know you were such a jokester.
We go. We're just having some fun here. Everything old new again with Michelle DeFranco, who is critiquing our work and trying to get an idea as to whether we should or should not continue with these characters, Al Capone and Leonardo da Vinci. Michelle?
Well, Doug, I really just want to say something to you just for a moment, which is I really think you should continue and you should really pursue this as a full-time profession. I think you could really be somebody.
Well, so you could tell that was Doug, because we really weren't telling you who the characters were.
Right, right. Absolutely. I could tell who was Doug right away. He was the one with the raspier voice, the more baritone.
Right.
Yeah.
Leonardo da Vinci himself. Right. Okay.
Yeah. And I thought that David, I thought that you, you could use a little vocal training, maybe some breathing techniques. You seemed a little bit tightened up. Your esophagus seemed to be closing, maybe a little hyperventilation going on. Whereas Doug really, it really was breathing. You could tell he was breathing deeply and relaxing through his.
You know, also it might be something when you get nervous, when you're in the presence of greatness. Sometimes your esophagus does tighten up, and maybe you need a nice glass of water or something. All right. Well, we'll come back.
Do we have a break coming
up? Yeah, let's take a break here, David.
Seems like we're going a little long here. Just trying to keep the show moving.
Let's get a glass of water for David, and we'll be right back. Right after this, there the old's new again.
Every time Brain and I are preparing to take over the world, we prepare ourselves with the joy of Everything Old is New Again.
Narf.
You're listening to Everything Old is New Again, including me, because we have the reboot. That is The Animaniacs, coming November 20th on Hulu.
There we go. That's Rob Paulson introducing us from a couple of shows back on Everything Old is New Again here. David, we're talking about characters inspired by this show, is inspired by Rob Paulson's review and critique of ours that was very, very nice. We've got this Michelle DeFranco here. She's in the bathroom right now taking a break.
Yeah. She's on a little break, as we would normally say.
Yeah, how do you think this is going?
Doug, what is going on? I mean, she hates everything I do, every character I do, and she's like deifying you. Do you have any other characters that I'm doing that I might be able to redeem myself with?
Well, we have the Universal Monsters that are coming on board in the clip here. Maybe that'll help you a little bit, you know? I mean, I don't know. But your best work is Sherlock Holmes and Fondue Guy, I would suggest. And so where we go from there?
But okay. All right. She's coming back.
Michelle DeFranco, yes. Thank you so much for joining us. We're having a great time here, getting some nice reviews. Yeah, I've got a come see one of those plays. What was the last play you did over at that playhouse? Was it the Roundabout or was it Music Man?
It was Long Day's Journey and Tonight by Eugene O'Neill, an exploration of a woman's descent into opioid abuse.
And that's a long one. That's probably about 3.5-4 hours, right?
Oh, yes. That's the abbreviated. That's the abridged version.
Okay, because Eugene O'Neill can be really exciting. And
profound.
Yeah, yes. That's the word. Thank you very much. Okay, now listen, speaking of profound, we had a time on our show where we had other characters, like the Universal Monsters came on board, and I just want to see, you know, let's get away from those standard characters, and let's hear something of some of these little clips here that we played a little ways back on our show about the Universal Monsters and how they would make out against the Avengers of today.
So what the entity and the mummy are saying here is that they're blaming the Abbott and Costello fiasco on Dracula. Dracula lost the contest on their behalf, and they've never gotten over that.
If you two fools were alive, I'd kill you right now. If you had an ounce of blood in you, I'd take it from you right now, but you don't. So that's why I'm really fed up with these two.
I love the trash talk by Dracula. It's great.
Right. Yeah, I was talking, remember, I had the idea was the Black Widow was artistic and maybe had some vocal qualities, and we were trying to figure out what would the Phantom of the Opera actually do on the battlefield?
Sing someone to death?
Right. He'd be good. He would turn the Black Widow. Does that make any sense? Let's get to the battlefield right now, all of us. Let's take a look what's happening here. What is this? Oh, I hear some music.
There she is around the corner. Take a look around the tree.
Oh, she sings like an angel.
Don't say angel. It seems like a million to me.
Where'd it go?
Who's that with her?
Is him. Singing nicely.
And she brought a band.
That's it. Everything goes new again. We see the end of it all.
So that's the Phantom taught her how to sing.
The Phantom turned her to the dark side. That may be the... Listen to that. Might be the deciding factor in the Battle Royale of the Avengers versus Universal Monsters.
What a weird, unexpected, and uninteresting ending.
We'll be back right after this, and everything old is new again. Was that uninteresting for a theater person like yourself? I would think that Phantom of the Opera ending there would be gargantuan. Michelle?
Well, it wasn't even clear to me, Doug, because we did this so long ago. What characters were we doing in there?
Well, I was Dracula, if you remember.
You were Dracula.
And then you were
brilliant,
the...
Brilliant.
Thank you. Thank you so much. And you were the...
See, that
was a departure. I didn't usually... You know, didn't do the usual, which I should have played
your
it.
Your range is just... It's inspiring, the range with which you can work.
Thank you, and
what characters did I do in that?
He did that monster business. That was the Frankenstein monster. And David also did the Invisible Man with the gentleman with the accent. Rather similar accent to the one that's Sherlock Holmes, if you heard.
Yeah, I think that David is relying too much on accents. He's you know, he thinks that, I'm asking, really, do you think that an accent is the character? Or do you ever delve into what's actually going on with the character? Or you just rely on the accent?
I mean, we're just trying to have some fun here, so... Well, I guess I don't really delve too much into the characters. I just...
It sounds like you're in pain. It doesn't really sound like you're having fun. Whereas Doug has a whimsical quality to his work that belies the preparation that obviously he is putting into the characters.
Thank you, Michelle. Well, I really appreciate that.
You're welcome,
Michelle.
Doug.
Your honesty is refreshing.
Well, no, I just don't want to... I want to speak the truth. I don't want to... lead you in the wrong direction. I mean, is this a hobby for you, or are you hoping to make a career out of this?
Well, it's more than a hobby.
Oh.
But I guess I...
It's an avocation, isn't it, would you say? Yeah. It's a little uncomfortable, getting a little hot here. Let's go to one more clip here of Barbecue Guy and Fondue Guy. Let's just get back to David's best work, and let's see if we can get something strong out of this. What's the next one? I'm very excited now. What is it? Kind of big. What is that?
This one is an apron, which I think will fit. And let me read.
It's a nice big apron, so it'll fit me. I love it.
And the description is a bit moronic, but let me read it to you.
Please do.
Read it to our listeners. I only drink on days that start with T. Tuesday, Thursday, today, tomorrow, Saturday, and Sunday.
You like that?
This is tremendous. I love this. It's my right size. It's the right saying. I say that saying all the time. I love this. The wife is going to freak when she sees. She's going to want one of these herself. This is I love Saturday and Funday. It's funny.
I guess I don't get the joke because
Saturday and Funday. You start with a T, T-H. Saturday and Funday.
If you're
like
only,
I'm a fun talker.
If you're only drinking on days that start with T, if you're saying today and tomorrow, doesn't that cover every day?
What if I'm on vacation? What if I'm talking about I want to have a drink on my vacation? Is vacation not Saturday tomorrow? The vacation's on next Saturday. So I'm going to say Saturday works. Saturday and Sunday is a vacation day.
So you're saying Saturday as Saturday.
Saturday and Sunday.
So that you can drink.
Absolutely. Everything starts with the letter T. You get what I'm saying to you?
But there's no mention
Tuesday,
of,
Wednesday.
What do you do on Monday and Wednesday?
Well, Monday's today and Wednesday's tomorrow.
But isn't...
There we go. How about that? So a little something, a little mention.
I'm just... The barbecue guy is... His effervescence, it just really resonates with me.
Effervescence?
And I just want to say he has a wife.
Yes, the character does have a wife. Yes, but she's never appeared on the show.
Oh, wow. I mean, I would be willing to, now that I'm done playing in the Long Day's Journey and tonight, I'd love to brush that character off and help you with that barbecue wife.
Well, I could see this coming from
you. Yeah.
That would be just so much fun.
Well, maybe we could think about doing something. We have another section of the show coming up right after the critique here, and we've got another 11 minutes. Maybe David and I, David could, you know, drink his water and get that esophagus, you know, opened up a bit.
Maybe you could start breathing deeply.
Do some exercise. Right.
Diaphragm.
Right. And you and I will work out a little bit of a skit or two, whatever we're going to do in the next section, and we'll reconvene.
That.
All right, good. And that would be, it's a great idea.
I didn't even have to participate if that's, I mean.
No, we need, we do
is that
need
an option?
Well, we do need a foil. That's the only problem. We need a foil.
Right,
so
right, right.
There has to be a boob in the, you know, the crowd. All right, listen, one more clip and we'll get back. I just want to hear, just to finish this off, we did have a young lady on once, and she did a nice participation in the show, and she was Batgirl. Listen to this.
The Seraphis.
Can I just say that I think librarians overall have been underestimated as a population, and I think that as a result, with the encouragement, of course, of my father, I'm going to go ahead and sign on to do the Avengers movie.
That's right. We're making the switch from DC to Marvel.
Oh, wow. You're going to be in the next Avengers flick.
I just really feel that Marvel is a place where my powers will be better represented and better appreciated. So
congratulations! That's great. I think the first thing you should do is contact the Black Widow. You know, team up, see how she's making out. She wears a similar outfit, and I don't know. You might be able to, you know, have a little camaraderie there.
And I think next time I come on your show, I think Dad, you can stay home.
Ah, oh, nice. See,
you see the growth here. You see the growth in this, young woman.
I take full credit for
it.
Thank
you. And the confidence.
And Douglas,
yes.
Would you like me to wear my costume next time, my uniform?
Please do. It will be, I would love to have a picture, a signed autograph.
Young lady, if you're wearing that costume, I'm coming with you. I don't trust this guy.
We'll be back in Everything Old Is New Again right after this. Oh, and don't go anywhere. We're still here. Michelle, that was a young lady that came on board and really had
was
some
fun. Was that Meryl Streep?
She did sound good, right? What do you think?
Oh my gosh. She's sounds like a highly trained artist.
Now, she was playing off of Bernie Brillstein, who was played by our very own David Cohen right here. I don't know if you got a chance to interact or see their interaction.
Well, it's interesting because it didn't seem to bring out the best in you, but she was, wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
Well, maybe, David, is there some lesson, some class or something you could, I don't know, join Michelle at? Michelle, you have some website or something?
We could definitely set something up. My coaching sessions start at a flat fee of $350 an hour.
An hour.
Yeah, that's kind of the discount family and friends
even for
rate.
Beginners like me.
Well, that is the beginner rate.
Well, let me ask you, Michelle, do you have a website we can go ahead and you know, promote here?
Well, our website is under construction right now. We're trying to raise some money to get the website.
Well, David,
going.
You could do two things at once. You could help yourself out. You could promote their business. What we'll do is we'll put it on our website, everythingoldisnewagain.biz. Everythingoldisnewagain.biz. You'll see a link for that when we come back. We'll be back with Michelle DeFranco, and we're going to do a skit. We'll try to create one right here and right now with Barbecue Guy and Barbecue Guy's wife. How about that?
Hey, you guys, this is Raphael of the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. And every night for pizza, we sit down and we listen to Everything Old is New Again. Turtle Power!
Ah, that's a smart man. That is Rob Paulsen, voice of hundreds of characters, you know, on television and Animaniacs and all over the world. So here we go. We are back on Everything Old is New Again, talking about characters. We have a wonderful critique with Michelle DeFranco, the artistic director of the Maplewood Players. And I really have had a wonderful time here with her. And she's asked to participate in a theme here of Barbecue Guy and Fondue Guy as Mrs. Barbecue Guy. And I think it's a great idea. We can have her join and show us her expertise, and maybe David can learn a thing or two from Michelle as we proceed, you know? So that would be nice. So I'm just thinking maybe it's a barbecue and during a pandemic and what? Fondue brings, what do you want to bring? Fondue will bring
maybe
something?
Maybe some veggie patties.
Okay,
you know,
good.
It's like a barbecue burger thing.
Right.
Doug. Matt, can I just ask you, just for a little insight into the inner life here of Mrs. Barbecue Guy,
yes.
What is her motivation?
She loves Barbecue Guy. It seems like to the world that he's a little bit aggressive and he's a little bit out there with his opinions. He's very straightforward, but she loves his honesty. In fact, she is just the same. She's just a woman that is straightforward, meat and potatoes. The rest of the world is all black and white. The rest of the business is just not of interest to her. What she wants to do is she wants to just enjoy her man and her life. That's it. And she doesn't like the annoyances of other, you know, little things that go on that kind of don't meet with her approval, if that makes sense.
Thank you, Doug. That is so clearly put. That really helps me. Thank you.
Yay.
Wow.
All right. So let's roll with it now. Let's go with it. Okay. And let's see. Now, Michelle, you look like you're doing a little yoga or something. What do you do here beforehand? What are you doing?
I'm doing a little deep relaxation breathing. I'm trying to get in touch with the character.
It's funny. Okay, David and I don't do any of that. Is that interesting?
Try to wrap it up because we have to get into this. It's just comedy.
Okay.
David, you're rushing her along a little bit. She needs to prepare. It's okay. Right,
I
Michelle?
Just need 27 more deep breaths.
Oh, okay. 27. David, what do you think?
How about three?
Okay, three.
Okay.
Just in the interest of time.
Would you suggest, David, why don't you take a breath? You do one at least to clear that esophagus.
Breathe deep. Count to six.
One.
No, breathe.
Oh.
Breathe. Three, four, five, six. Let it out.
Okay,
four.
Good. Now you ready for fondue?
That's so much better.
All right, here we go. So next thing you hear, we'll be at the... Now, I don't have any sound effects, unfortunately, because we didn't prepare for this. So we'll make up. We're at the barbecue as we speak, and I'll just start it with fondue. You're walking in, and we get rolling, okay? Okay.
Do it.
I'm going to take my breath. That's good advice, Michelle. It really is good. Thank you. It puts me right there. Okay. You don't have, you have a little problem.
Can we just
with
get into it, people?
Okay, here we go. I just think Michelle's advice is so critical. Okay.
Thanks.
Fondue guy here. You're walking through the door here. Fondue barbecue. It's going strong here. Mrs. Barbecue, thank you very much. Do me a favor. Leave the barbecue. I'm going to leave the barbecue for a minute. Watch those steaks, please, and those hamburgers.
Sure will,
Fondue, come on in. We're over here. The pandemic, I know, is happening, but this is a mask-free zone. We're going to have some fun here at the barbecue. Fondue.
Well, first of all, thanks to you both for inviting me. I will remove my mask and just request that we socially distance. And
what do you mean social? What is?
I presume you're Mrs. Barbecue Guy. A pleasure to meet you. I'm Fondue Guy.
Hi, Fondue Guy. I've heard so much about you. What do you have there in that Tupperware?
He always brings something.
Well,
this guy. Yeah.
Since it's a barbecue, I thought it would be appropriate to bring these wonderful veggie patties to grill on the barbecue.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, honey, honey, honey.
Oh, boy. Yeah. Listen, do me a favor. Fondue, hold off. It's a what? It's a what? A veggie what?
Veggie burgers?
Well, how could you have a hamburger without any meat? You put vegetables on top of the burger.
Listen, I've heard such wonderful things about you, but I just want to make sure that there's no quinoa in those burgers. This is a strictly quinoa-free zone.
There's no quinoa, fortunately, for all of us.
Is there any barley?
There's a little barley.
How about talking about barley? How about some barley and hops? There's a whole container over there. Yes, thank you. Take a look. You got so much there. You got all the beers. You got Mrs. Barbecue, tell me a favor. List a couple of the beers. You got the Michelob. You got the Bud. What else we got over there for this guy?
High quality beers.
Oh, yes. We have Pabst Blue Ribbon. We have Schlitz, Schmitz. Snitz.
And the Half and Raffa. The Half and Raffa from...
Honey Wheat Ale, the A&P Deluxe brand.
Yeah, it's good.
Well, as a counterpoint, I thought you guys might enjoy a wonderfully full-bodied Merlot that I brought, imported from France.
No.
Mrs. Barrow.
This is... Beer Fest 2020, Fondue Guy. We're having an outdoor barbecue beer fest.
My apologies.
Honey, didn't you tell him?
I did. He doesn't listen to everything I say. Tell him what to do with the wine. Just be nice about it in some way. Just tell him something to do with that wine. We'll use it another time or something.
You can take your wine, your Merlot, and you can go in through the front door, down the hall, and put it in the refrigerator for us.
Perfect. There you go. We'll have it another time.
If you don't refrigerate Merlot.
Well, you don't have to. If you refrigerate it, you don't have to put the ice in it. It's perfect. There's no ice needed.
It's cold already. Keep it with me here, and I'll enjoy it later at home alone.
No. Just put it in the refrigerator, and we'll cook something with it. When we make chili next week, honey, we'll put it in the chili.
Tremendous. What a great idea. I love it. That's a great idea. We used that Beaujolais he sent over the other day for that, too. It came out very nice. So thank you for sending that wine, by the way.
I'm glad to hear my wine.
The baked beans and the hot dogs with the Beaujolais.
To hear my wine is being put to good use.
We used the wine instead of the beer.
I'm a little hesitant to enter your home again due to the pandemic and social distancing. So I will just place it here, and you can consume it later as you wish.
You know what we could do? We just bought that boat. When that boat gets delivered, we take this wine, and we do like they do in the movies, and just I'll have you crash it over the top of the boat.
Yes! Oh, that's a great idea,
all right,
sweetie.
We got the... Yeah.
Oh, right.
Congratulations on your... Boat. I didn't know you.
Well, it's only one of these. It's more or less a rowboat. We're just going to do it to have some fun. But that's okay. We're going to have a nice time with the. Listen,
That's such a great idea. What a great way to use your bottle of wine as our.
And it might even stain it. It's white, so we may have that. We may have that remnant of that Beaujolais or whatever it might be all over the boat and stay there for a while. We'll remember you forever.
I love that idea.
Well, I'm pleased. You didn't like the veggie burgers, and I understand that, but at least you're putting my gift of the red wine to some use.
Hey, here's a beer. Take a beer, will you, please?
Sure.
We're more of a red meat family here.
Yes, I've learned that over the years with your husband.
Although there is some great, nice surprise we got for your fondue. Mrs. Barbecue, tell them what we're having for dessert today.
We're having a wonderful Jell-O mold with candy corn and lifesavers.
It's okay. You can tell them.
I also see a fondue pot.
Yeah, you can tell them. Don't worry. I know it.
Are you surprising me with a fondue?
No, we're having a chocolate fondue.
A chocolate fondue?
Yes. We thought you would enjoy it.
She heard the review, if you remember our Thanksgiving show, which you can hear on everything old's new again. If you haven't heard it before. And at the end, we had a nice recipe for a chocolate fondue. And so Mrs. Barbecue has really enjoyed that. She's going to...
Yes, we melted 75 Nestle Crunch Bars. And we're going to be dunking... different types of cake, right?
Let's do some cake. We add a little bit of cake. We got some of that bread that you like. What's that kind of bread
the bread.
But it's all healthy. It's all nice. That's why. Like, by the way, Mrs. Barbecue wanted to know, and she had asked me to ask you, but I think she's going to ask herself. She's very strong with these things. What's the healthy aspect of the fondue?
Well, I would say it's not chocolate and sweets. My classic fondue comprises mostly of various cheeses, organic cheeses, I might add, from around the world, artisanal breads, again, varying in quality and variety.
But what's healthy about bread and cheese? Bread and cheese aren't healthy at all. Am I right?
I think I agree 100%. I'm trying to figure this out. What are you talking about?
An organic cheese, for example, I bought a wonderful Chèvre the other day, imported from France.
Chèvre.
And it was quite delicious. If it's organic and eaten in the quantities that are, you know, reasonable.
I think, okay, listen, it's wonderful. I'm glad you're going to continue to barbecue. That's terrific. But I got to get going. And so we're going to get going. As far as the air on the air is going, the barbecue will continue.
Yes.
But we'll cut out right now, right here. Now, that was good. Michelle, we are running out of time here on the radio show. So very much enjoyed having you on the show. Very much enjoyed. I think we're going to get great feedback on that. Thank you so much for unwinding and so teaching welcome. Us a little something about the characters. Thank you so much.
So welcome. It was a pleasure.
You have anything coming up in the theater over by you there in Maplewood?
Oh, yes. We're going to be doing Troilus and Cressida, one of Shakespeare's greatest works. And we're going to be doing it with marionettes.
Oh, nice.
Silhouette.
Yeah, puppets, huh?
Yeah, I'd like to see that. That's something different.
Yes, it's an artistic experiment. If
so it's
will.
The one you make
avant-garde.
A left guard. Make a left turn.
Doug, maybe you can be a guest lecturer over there.
What do you think, Michelle?
I think that would be just awesome, unless you want to conduct a little talk back after the show.
Interesting. I would be happy to do that. Sure. Okay.
That would be wonderful.
So maybe, is there a little, is it possible? Is there, I don't know, do you have like a restaurant around the corner there someplace I can prepare a little ahead of time and we'll meet and talk about it?
Well, yeah, there's a Denny's around the corner. We Perfect. Could meet up over there.
All right. I'll come down, David. I know David's probably busy, but I'll come down and.
This is just a delight for me. Thank you.
Oh, this
so
would be great
much.
Because then, Doug, I can be one of your students. That would be awesome.
Oh, that's right. That's
probably learned so much from you.
So, Michelle, you meet me at the Denny's. David, you meet me at the Catherine Sienna basement afterwards. Okay? This we'll reconvene at that point. Sound good?
Yeah, great.
That sounds great.
Thank you so much for your time. And everything old is new again.